credit card fraud cost merchants and banks billions of dollars a year, and they are getting very serious about combating it. In the old days, most credit card fraud was kind of simple. Somebody would steal your wallet or steal a credit card and use that credit card until such point in time it got declined, and that was pretty much it. They may have charged a few thousand dollars worth of stuff before you, the holder of the card, found out, and that was the extent of the fraud. Now things are getting a lot more sophisticated on a lot of fronts. First, there are electronic skimming devices that people have figured out how to attach to cash registers at department stores, and some of them are so small and innocuous that even the clerk does not realize that there's some device attached to the cash register. And what that device is doing is copying off all of the credit card information to literally hundreds, if not thousands, of customers. That's then compromised, and that information can be used to charge hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of merchandise before the scam is discovered. Now, it's almost impossible to, in today's day and age, to engage in any kind of activity without using the mails or the wires. Any type of fraudulent activity in which the mails are used or the wires are used can be indicted as a mail fraud case or a wire fraud case. Of course, the standard of proof is much higher. That is proof beyond a reasonable doubt. If you find yourself being investigated or an agent wants to talk to you about possible involvement in a credit card fraud scheme, you should not talk with them. You should tell them that you want to consult with an attorney first. And you should retain the services of an attorney that's skilled at handling credit card fraud cases.